Okay, guys, we're going to, real quickly, I'm going to show you a quick test that's really nice to do while we're taking our transmissions apart right now, is testing of the neutral switch, because it's so easy and we have so much access to get to it. You guys have seen me draw some stuff in the classroom where basically we have a battery. Okay, so I'm going to make this the negative, I'll make this the positive. So this is my ground, right? Out of here, what do we always have right away? What should we have? We have fuses, right? And then out of here, let's say we have a key switch. Getting ahead of myself. Supposed to be a key switch, right? And we go through, and then we're gonna have a bulb, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is a light bulb, okay? We'll just attach that guy right there. And then we're gonna go here, and we're going to basically have a plunger style switch. And this is threaded into the engine case. And the engine case is attached to ground as well. Okay? So if this plunger makes contact, what happens to the neutral light?
It goes on.
When it makes contact.
It goes on.
When it makes contact, it's going to light up. When this, in this drawing right here where I show them not touching or it's disconnected, that means that the light's going to go out. Okay, so as we shift through the gears, we'll look at a couple of different ways that this is done here in the lab, but it's a real easy test. We got a multimeter here. If you guys, I'm not going to do real intense multimeter training right now, but just kind of fun. So as we look here, you can see the ohm scale.
Yep.
That ohm symbol. I always like to cycle a meter, don't have leads touching here. I like to have go to the position I want. And this is an auto-ranging meter. Our black always goes in our black or our common. And then you'll see here on the red, you'll see that ohm symbol. So we're doing the right kind of testing. You guys will get certified on this in January. Then what you want to do is you always want to touch your leads together and zero it out. It's real common to have that one or two tenths of an ohm there for continuity. Just the length of the leads. You could see on ours for training purposes here, we actually wired an external fuse because when you guys hook these up, we like the fuse to blow rather than the meter. There are fuses in the meter, but it takes screwdrivers and you gotta pop the case off. And the fuse that's inside this meter, I'm pretty sure they're like 12 or 15 bucks just for one fuse. So a little trick we saw on the internet one time was to wire an external one and have it be sacrificial. It's actually even too small. It's only a 7.5 amp fuse, and it really should be fused for 10 amps. So for what we're doing 99% of the time, we can't hurt the meter and we can't hurt components. So what I like to do is I did a quick test here. You also, if you want, you can push this buzzer right here, and you see where this buzz symbol came at the top? It looks like a volume.
Mm-hmm.
See that? And it's good for real quick stuff, because let's just see what the integrity of this engine case is. So I'm touching it in multiple spots, and you hear it buzzing. Mm-hmm. So that means we have a good connection or good continuity, right? And we should. It's the same exact piece. So I could test a piece that's threaded to the case, like the oil pressure relief valve, and I have good continuity too. So what that tells me is that anything that's bolted to this case should have the availability to conduct electricity. Make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So real quickly here, it doesn't matter. And there's no polarity on continuity here for this. So I'm going to just test and see. Okay, so right now, notice how I got something, then it went away.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you need a good connection here. Now watch this. I'll just kind of touch right here lightly. Nothing. I can touch this loosely and basically have it not work. What I'm trying to simulate is a light bulb that wouldn't work because of a bad connection. Okay? So this tells me that I have continuity, but what I really need to make sure is that it will lose its continuity too for when I shift out of that gear. Does that make sense? So I'm gonna go ahead and touch this now. I have no continuity. You guys wanna shift it back? You'll feel it snap. One more. There you go. Okay, off, on. It's that simple. That's how we test that neutral switch. Okay. So what's happening on the switch itself is there's a, did Brian, you said yours was handy here. He has a little bit different design, but it, you'll see it's does the same purpose here. He has a switch that's threaded into his case, and what happens is this rotates around, that's going to hit a little plunger pushing the switch in, and oh, there it is right there. It's nice and handy, right there. So you have two switches on there, mm-hmm. And does anybody have an idea what maybe the other switch might be for? It's a cruiser motorcycle.
Overdrive.
What?
Yep.
There's an overdrive?
Mm-hmm. Yep. So on this bike, it's going to have a light that'll pop up on the dash telling me he's in top gear or his overdrive gear. Anytime you see two switches like that. Another possibility, not on this cruiser bike, but if it was an ATV, could it be reverse?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, something like that. But so that plunger hits this, and when this ramps up, that causes the plunger to go in, and on my little crude drawing here, that pushes that plunger down, makes the metal-metal contact, and makes the light work. Here's my point of this. You guys are doing a transmission inspection lab, and I'm going, hey, how's the neutral switch work? Would you agree this is unbelievably overlooked?
Yep.
And you might have people bringing you engines where you don't have a way to test the dash or the wiring or whatnot. If somebody goes back home, puts their engine back in, and says, hey, my neutral light doesn't work, you could say, well, it's definitely your wiring or your dash. It's not the switch because I tested it. Just make that kind of a common practice because it's so easy to do now. On the Kawasaki here, if I remember correctly, what they have is they don't have this ramp, and it's basically a flat dish, if you will. And what they do is on the aluminum, they take and they have like a black plastic that covers up all of it but one little spot. And so when that switch rolls around and hits that one bare spot, now that creates a complete path, and then you have the neutral light operates. If this isn't located properly, remember in your lab sheet I'm asking you how the shift drum is secured or how it's located. If this is allowed to float around or be loose, could that be a problem that the switch doesn't work?
Yeah.
Yeah, now's the time to catch all that. Guys, there's just your little quick 5-minute demonstration on how to test your neutral switches. They're going to be in different spots on your different engines, and you might have to have me point them out to you. Okay?
All right.